fell out of bed, dragged a comb across my head. Found my way downstairs and drank a cup, and looking up, I noticed I was late. Found my coat and grabbed my hat, made the bus in seconds flat.
Good. This is 101 FM. Good morning. 6:22 in the morning. It's 47.
6,600 now. 6:18. You're getting up and getting off with the Power 96 Morning Zoo.
Well, I was too. That was the real shocker. It's 16 after 6 in the morning at Z95.5, Monday, the 15th of May.
Big Burton gets you up every morning.
The Fox 619. How you doing? My name's Andy Savage.
And I'm Steve Courtney. How are you?
We have the most music in the morning.
The most!
70s for a high right now. It's a 47 in Wall Lake, the same. Here Detroit's only all classic rock, 94.7 WCSX. With the Beach Boys and Friends.
Good morning. This is Mr. Cooley with the morning announcements. June 4th, 1989.
Yeah!
Holy smokes, guys. This is it, the big one. Graduation just a couple more days away. Let's take a look at the class of 1989. Let's take a look at some of the pictures, the images, and listen to some of the songs that made it so great here at Clarkston Senior High.
One of the things I think I'll remember most about this class, and I saw some signs of it with the class of 87 at Clarkston High School and the class of 88, is this one has made as maybe its legacy, caring and involvement in service to others. The class has come together and has done a lot of nice things academically, athletically, musically, in drama, lots of things to come together as a class. But first and foremost, I guess, is the fact that I've lived with this class for 3 years, and so I know them well, and I know them to be very talented, caring people. And Clarkston students, and especially seniors, have really come on board with the service component. And so one of the truly nice things is that you have students who not only are talented individuals, but they're caring people. And they care not just about their peers and their classmates, but they care about the community of Clarkston. And that's a memory that I think I'll really carry about this group.
Okay, here we are again. We're interviewing Heather Moe, who's a quite eager prospect here for an interview in the cafeteria. So, Heather, can you tell us some of your plans for the future?
Well, next year I'm going to Michigan State University.
I'm going to Oakland University next fall.
Oh, do we have a planned major here or not?
No.
No. Okay, Mr. Rice, yeah, your I'm plans for the future?
I'm a Bronco next year.
A Bronco? Oh, you seem quite excited about that.
Oh, yeah. Get away from home.
University of Michigan?
Western. Probably Central.
U of M Flint.
U of M Ann Arbor.
It's a temporary law.
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti.
With cheese.
That's lasagna.
Well, this is our version of spaghetti.
So what do you people over here think of their version of spaghetti?
No, it's great.
I'm not having the spaghetti. This is vitamin D, and this is just 2%.
What am I doing, Dave? Well, in the late summer, mid-August, I'll be heading to the Superior University of Southern California. Yes, Vern, that's USC, Vern.
Hey, Vern, who's better, Notre Dame or USC?
Notre Dame.
The team is going to beat Notre Dame next year? Yeah, that team, Vern.
No, I hate USC.
And from there, just be getting a tan. That's about it.
There's nothing better than a Spartan, though, Tom.
Alma, Dave. Well, I don't know, Dave. You know, it seems to me that Alma would just attract a bunch of squirrel-worshipping, maple syrup-sucking type of people, you know, Dave?
Where's Elmo?
What's Elmo?
In terms of marriage, we know that the young ladies are going to wait until, in many instances, until their late 20s and early 30s to, one, get married, and two, to have children if they do have children.
Do you have any plans for the future?
This July I'll be getting married and moving to New Hampshire.
Oh, married?
Married.
Whoa.
Time out.
Oh, pardon me.
Time out.
Wait, married?
Yeah.
Who's the lucky guy?
Daniel Reed.
What's it like for a senior? Well, I think it becomes a very emotionally charged time. And when I say charged time, what I'm suggesting is that, you know, the realization that it's a singular time only, that they're doing everything for the last time. You know, the last pep rally, the last senior dinner together, the last dance, the last baseball game, the last function where there's going to be any kind of consistency that they've known throughout their life, and that's school. And this is, Gail Sheely said, this is one of the rites of passages right here. We're going from being a teenager, to being a young adult. Literally a young adult with all the responsibilities and all the situations. And I think it usually is that's a senior dinner or like activities at the end of the school year or graduation itself, when people recognize that they're no longer going to be ever again in this kind of a situation where they can count on coming to school in the morning, they can count on seeing Mr. Cooley in the morning. If I was to describe the graduating class in 1989, I think I would capsulize it in these three words: caring people, committed people, and concerned people.
Are kind of sad, you know?
Huh.
I mean, all those sedentary animals can't move, can't run free. They just sit there and drink and shovel food in their faces.
Sorry, man, there's no kind of life.
Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to WrestleMania 20.
Wrestle!
We've got an action-packed card planned for today. We have the Galloping Gaze, including three title matches and a Royal Ruckus to conclude the action.
I've got two words for you, Esther. Prima donna. You're nothing but a prima donna. You're a hot dogger and a grandstander, and I'm about to do something about it, baby. You're on down, Esther. Yeah!
And the suplex! Oh my god! Oh my gosh! Oh! What was that? That was a new move! New move on WrestleMania 20!
Well, they're pretty good, really.
Really?
Yeah.
Are we pretty wild drivers?
No, most of them are pretty good kids.
All right. And any words of advice for the graduating seniors?
Just good luck to them, and best of luck in the future.
It's fun being at Clarkston. Had a blast, and it was fun going on the friend with my friends on the weekend.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, we're here with Dwight, Class 89's favorite janitor. Dwight, what do you think of that Class 89?
I think they're great. It's great.
How do they compare in the messes they leave in lunch to compare to other classes?
Not.
They about the same?
No.
Are they worse?
Not better.
No, they're better. Oh, that's exciting to hear. Any certain people are going to miss the Class 89 when they leave?
Sure.
All right, Dwight, all right. A few words.
Man, a few words. Thank you very much, Dwight.
Thank you.
Oh, yeah, it's great. It's awesome. The best. Looking forward to getting out, though. Enjoy it.
This is Jennifer and I and her best friends.
I'm Cameron.
Obviously, she doesn't want to admit that, but we are.
Brian has a full-grown beard now. Looks quite nice. Real sexy, real fuzzy. We're trying to take him to the Paul Sebastian salon, get something really chic done with it, gel, color, something different, you know. But I am tardy for class at this time, so I think I must depart. But it was great fun being in this little film. See y'all later.
At high school? High school's really fun, man. I have a lot of new friends, and being vice president's really fun.
Yes?
So, Tanya, what are your feelings here about Clarkston High School? What will be some of the memories you'll leave with?
I love this school. There's the best of friends here, you know.
You're lying.
And you have friends like these guys, yep, that throw milk and sandwiches at you the whole lunch hour.
We're not going to play that one tonight anyway. All right, we'll do it. One condition, you've got to join in, sing it out, right? I think I lost this lady. She walked up to me and she asked me to dance. I asked her her name and in a top brown voice she said Lola. L-O-L-A. Lola.
first runner-up is number 24, Jennifer O'Hara. Clarkson Junior Miss for 1988-89 goes to number 10, Kelly Duty.
You know, I think I'd probably give you the words of advice that my mother never gave me, and certainly your mother will never give you. When you wake up on June 8th and you get up out of bed, take some risks today. We never ever get any place without taking a few risks, and that maybe makes for exciting life, but it also makes for a thoughtful life.
Well, with the class of 89 around, it's I must say it's been pretty special. The kids that I've come to know, since I've been here at the school for 3 years now, the class of 89 has also been here the same length of time, and I've come to appreciate. No, don't put words in my mouth, little weasel. Appreciate is a good word, though. There's a lot of nice kids here. I've made good friends, and I'm going to be sad to see them all go this year.
If I was to do that, what I'd suggest for the graduating class of 1989 is that they look around and they appreciate those things and those people who cared with them, shared with them, and was committed to them. For the last 12 years of their lives. Here's from Mr. Cooley to the class of 89, the best of luck in all you choose to do. Thank you for the memories.
This is Dr. Burek. I'd like to wish the class of 89 every success in this life as they leave us on June 7th, that they're happy, they're successful, and they come back to see us.
To the class of 1989, I would like to wish you good luck and thank you for all the memories. I will enjoy them forever. I appreciated you. Good luck.